Hello and welcome everyone to the first episode of the Startup Spotlight series, where we talk to founders and builders building cool things on top of Snowflake. Today we're going to have Harry from Modelbit, who's going to tell us really cool things he's building directly on top of Snowflake for data science and machine learning. Harry, welcome to the show today.
Yeah, thank you for having me. It's great to be here. My name is Harry Glaser. I'm the CEO of Modelbit. And Modelbit is the fastest way for data scientists to deploy machine learning models, and especially to deploy the machine learning models directly into their Snowflake data cloud.
Yeah, no, I love that. And I think we're going to dive deeper into like the trends that sort of led to this. But before we get into that, we'd love to learn more about your journey as a founder, right? This is not your first shot at doing this. Tell us a little bit more about sort of like the first round and how did you end up here at Modelbit?
Sure. Very fortunate, I guess, to have had a career in startups. I founded a company called Periscope Data over 10 years ago. It was a cloud BI company, and we were very fortunate to be able to build that up over the last decade and eventually sell that company in a successful exit. But coming out of that experience, I think there was almost nothing else we'd rather do than another startup. And so my co-founder and I got right back on the horse, and we're now building Modelbit, our second company.
Yeah, no, and I love that. I sort of love the drive that you have going forward. And sort of what I would love to learn is, what were some of the things that you experienced as a first-time founder that now are sort of been like learning lessons that are now being sort of thought in terms of how you think about teams, the technology that you're using to build the product and everything like that?
It's so funny. I mean, the thing that matters the most about a startup in the early days, really all the days, is product market fit, right? Do the customers and users really, truly, desperately want the thing that you're building? And so we were fortunate at our first company at Periscope to have really strong product market fit, and the customers really loved the product, which is awesome because we screwed up pretty much everything else. We were first-time founders, we were young, we didn't know much about hiring and management and technology choices and all the things that go into building a company, but we had a great team and we had great customers and they showed us the way. And we're fortunate to have some experience at all of those things, but you still gotta put in the work to get the product market fit. You still gotta get to know your users deeply and really truly feel their user problems and build a product that they really desperately love. And we're fortunate again to have the early phases of product market fit. I guess lightning can strike twice. It's been a great journey for us.
Yeah, no, and I think sort of like talking about product market fit right now, if you ask anybody, like, what's your biggest challenge in data science and machine learning, they're going to say probably like taking models into production. So this sort of is a good segue. We're like, tell me a little about Modelbit. What is this, the play in the data science and machine learning space? And sort of how did you come up with this new startup idea?
Absolutely. So we were fortunate again at our first company at Periscope to be present almost at the creation of the cloud data platform. And it started with cloud data warehouses like Snowflake. And that created the center of gravity where all the data teams were moving to a cloud data stack, right? All their BI would be in the cloud now, all their ETL would be in the cloud now, all of those different things. And we participated as a BI company, but we observed over that 10 years that data scientists were not moving into the cloud. They were still on these data science Jupyter notebooks locally on their laptops, and still they haven't really moved to the cloud. And we were sort of professionally surprised by that. And then we hired our own data science team at Periscope, and they worked locally in Jupyter notebooks, and they really struggled to get their work into the cloud to deploy their models. And so that was something we were eager to tackle a second time. And as you said, the biggest, most acute challenge is the data scientist builds a machine learning model. They score their leads, they predict fraud, they predict whether a customer is going to churn. And now what, right? It's working on their laptop, works on my box, and they can't get it. It needs to run in the warehouse, right? It needs to run over all the user records, all the customer records, and say, are they a churn risk or not? And they weren't able to do that. So we built that sort of point solution, but that becomes the wedge, right? They deploy that model successfully with Modelbit. It's really easy, right? That's great. But now you want to deploy many more versions of that model, and you want to deploy many more models. And now you have need for version control, need for CI/CD, need for code review, right? Need for collaboration features and management, right? All of these things, logging, load balancing, that go into managing a lot of code running at scale, which is where the data scientists are going to end up being. So over time, we provide solutions to all those platforms, and we become the cloud platform sitting on top of Snowflake, where they can manage all their machine learning models running in production.
Yeah, and it's super interesting. You sort of talk about a few trends that were happening over the last 10 years that sort of have made this product market fit get better and better and better, right? The move to the cloud, tons of data being brought to the cloud. I think the advancement in open source, but sort of like the security risks that came with open source as well. And so sort of, I think the two things that ended up coming is, how do I keep my data secure? How do I maintain the processing also secure? And so I'm just wondering, like, as you were seeing this in your own team and then in other teams, as you started to talk to more prospects and customers, how did then this become sort of like a key phase in like doing integrations with things like Snowpark, which provides Python support directly inside the cloud platform?
Yeah, it's a great question. I mean, we have been so lucky that the overall move of IT spend to the cloud and IT to the cloud, corporate IT to the cloud, and specifically the move of data to the cloud driven by Snowflake has been fabulous for us in our careers. And so that's been wonderful. Thank you. But your point about security, both the security and privacy of the data and the security and privacy of the compute and processing itself, is a really great point. And it's really hard for a startup to get started in the data industry for that reason. You're two people, three people, four people, and you're trying to convince a big customer that they should trust you. They're just not going to, right? And maybe they shouldn't, right? But when you build something on top of Snowflake, and the way our architecture works is, we run a web application where you can do all these management tasks, right? But the compute and data lives in the customer's Snowflake environment. And as a result, we can tell our customers, oh, the compute and data, that's going to stay in your Snowflake environment. And if you have questions about your security and privacy, you should call Snowflake and ask them. And they never do because they trust Snowflake. And that's a great way for us to sort of move beyond that question and onto the ultimate questions of user value, which is great for us.
Yeah. And so I think it's sort of great to see how the fact that we designed Snowpark to be extensible is being a really great way for startups like Modelbit to provide additional value in terms of things like Snowpark for Python, which lets you bring that complex processing into the platform. But tell me a little bit more, what is that extra functionality that Modelbit brings that sort of makes it really easy for data scientists to not depend on like machine learning engineers and other teams that sort of slow down that process from development to production of models?
Absolutely. So the way Modelbit works when you're first getting started with it, like we said, that first wedge where you deploy a model, you're in your Jupyter notebook, you've built a machine learning model, you call one line of Python, you say modelbit.deploy, and you give it the machine learning model, and Modelbit carries that model into your Snowflake warehouse, and then gives you a link to modelbit.com, where you can manage that running model and see the logs and, you know, deploy new versions and then do version control and share it with your teammates and all that good stuff, right? So Snowflake with Snowpark for Python provides this storage layer with the data itself that's going to be have predictions run on it, and now this compute layer where the machine learning model runs there. And then Modelbit provides all that management. So let's say you've got now 10 models and you need to organize them, or you've got a ninth version of a model running and you're about ready to deploy a 10th version, you're going to send it to your manager or your tech lead for code review, right? And you can do that right in your, say, GitHub or your GitLab, where you can say, look, I'm about to push this new version from my staging branch into production. Can you code review this for me? And then you do, like, say, a GitHub pull request, and now that model is going to deploy a new version to production again in Snowflake. And you can even ensure that the tests are passing before you do that. So Modelbit provides all of this management, but critically, as you need it, right? The first model deployment is super easy. But then as you're doing your fifth or sixth, or you're bringing your teammates on, you need a little more structure. So you add in those Modelbit features, and Modelbit provides all that management and structure while Snowflake provides the compute and storage.
Yeah, and I really like that, because really the end story for machine learning and machine learning operations, it's scale, right? Repeatability and all these things that both in the storage of the data, the processing of the data, and of course the management of the models, which is sort of a thing that everyone's realized is not as easy to do as everyone thought it would be. And so this brings me to the next question, which is, right, the sort of the world of MLOps is starting to come in.
Yeah.
You're at the right place at the right time. But what are some of the things that you see moving forward in this world, both in general in terms of market, sort of like opportunities for others to come in, as well as where is Modelbit going next with the development of the platform?
Yeah, MLOps it's a relatively new category, but it is a category. And what we mostly see in MLOps are technologies and companies that are targeting relatively hardcore experienced machine learning engineers, right? Where they are happy to take code that was prototyped in a notebook, rewrite it for scale, deploy it in some kind of more advanced, more custom way. And that's relatively common, especially at big tech or deep tech companies, right? But the long tail, the 99% of companies, can benefit from machine learning and data science. And these data scientists are generally just writing Python in a notebook. And there has been a gap in terms of tooling for them. Right? We want their models to run in production, and we want them to grow, right? One of the great things about startups is how the company itself can help its users grow in their career and acquire more advanced capabilities and all that stuff. So these data scientists have a career journey to go on as Modelbit customers or even just in their careers where they can learn more and more advanced techniques and become more and more like these machine learning engineers if that's what they want, and Modelbit can help them with that. So we think there's a big, I mean, it's one of the data science is one of the fastest growing job categories that there is. And so that, you know, tooling for them and help for them and content for them is a big market opportunity, and it's where we're excited to take the company.
Yeah, and I really love that path of sort of like giving the data science independence to do whatever they need without being bottlenecked by all these infrastructure teams, and sort of how Modelbit and Snowflake can do that together. I really enjoyed our conversation today, Harry, but before we leave, tell us, how can people learn more about Modelbit?
Yeah, thank you for asking the question. I appreciate it. We're at Modelbit, Modelbit.com. And my email is Harry, Harry, at Modelbit.com for anyone who has any questions.
Awesome. Thanks for sharing that, Harry. And of course, thank you to all the viewers that joined us today. Please do email Harry for all your data science and machine learning problems and how to get your models into production. And of course, please do subscribe to join our next episode so you can learn more about founders and builders who are building really cool things directly on top of Snowflake. See you in the next one. Bye.